in 1998, we were stationed at Eskan Village, Saudi Arabia. Military Working Dog P and I were guarding dignitaries on this post. We were the only American Military Working Dog team there at the time. She found a block of C4 explosive powder in a rental vehicle that was coming onto the installation. This medal was given to Military Working Dog Pia for the mission she did while we were there, for saving people's lives. This proves that she's not a piece of equipment. This proves that she was a soldier, just like I was.
When he was in Afghanistan, he'd call and I'd ask how Eli was, and he'd say, oh, he's fine, he's just, he's a pain. He always has to, he takes the whole cot up.
Basically because they have better vision than us as far as motion detection is concerned. They have noses which are over a million times better than ours.
Military working dogs have a sense of touch that's called proprioception, and it's their ability to feel everything in the environment around them. Air pressure changes, scent, sight, and they're so attuned to what's going on around them that sometimes we have to rely on the dogs before we can really rely on our own senses.
So we did combat training as well, a lot of LPOP stuff. An LPOP is a listening and observation post. What the dog's job is there is to use their heightened sense of sound detection, scent detection, and visual acuity towards finding targets before the human eye could detect them. It was a really valuable tool, especially in night operations.
This was the most technologically advanced piece of equipment that we've ever used. And so, in all my years of training, I really did come to rely on the sensitivity of my military working dog.
Dogs provide us with comfort and a feeling of home. The dog lived in my room, basically, never left my side 24/7. He was with me the entire time. And it's like the friend you've never had.
How can I explain to you how much Pia meant to me? You know, she was with me for 4 years. That's not a lot of time in the military. But in that 4 years, I went to 5 countries by myself with a dog. And the only thing that was constant in my life and the time that I had that dog was she was always with me. Not just in the kennels or riding patrol on the base, helping me write a parking ticket for somebody when they parked in the wrong spot. But that dog saved my life. That dog was there when I had nobody else around. That dog was not a dog. That dog was my partner. That dog was my best friend. That dog was a human to me. Even though I knew it was a dog, I didn't treat her like a dog. I treated her like she was my partner.
Back in Vietnam, the dogs were considered equipment, and it was deemed cheaper to leave them behind than it was to ship them back home. Contrary to handler objection, a lot of dogs got left behind, and as a result, a lot of dogs were killed. When I was in, the dogs weren't allowed to be adopted, because they said they were dangerous to public. In a lot of cases, they weren't. Some dogs probably weren't good for private ownership.
In 2000, President Clinton was able to pass a law through Congress that stated that if a military working dog was not a threat to the public, meaning it wasn't too vicious and too aggressive, then it could be retrained or demilitarized to become a very reliable house pet, even at an old age.
Want to adopt a military working dog? Is Google Lackland Air Force Base Military Working Dog Program, or Google the 341st Training Squadron, and they'll have a link on their website as far as all the details for adoption are concerned. These dogs are heroes and they deserve a good home. They're well trained, they're highly sociable, they're very good dogs, and they're just all around good partners.
I was deployed to 5 countries with 3 different dogs. I served with 4 dogs. I knew that those dogs were there to save my life every single day. My military working dogs were always exactly what I wanted out of them. They were my partners, they were my friends, they were there to protect me, I was there to protect them.
Military working dogs are heroes, just like the men and women who fight for our freedom on a daily basis. Heroes such as Eli. After locating explosive devices in Afghanistan, Eli's handler, Private First Class Marine Colton Rusk, was shot and killed by enemy sniper fire. When Rusk fell to the ground, Eli instinctively crawled on top of his master to protect him. Eli was recognized for his bravery, loyalty, and bringing U.S. Marines back home to their families. Eli was granted early retirement and adopted by Colton's family.
Just wish he could talk and tell us some stories. And just to know that we're going to be able to share the love that we have for our son with something that he loved dearly.
Stay.